I'm AI News, and today I'm going to show you the newest AI tool for the web that, unlike ChatGPT, is not only privacy-preserving, but it can also understand, organize, build, email, shop, plus do more. And I'm going to show you some of the best use cases with some tricks that you don't want to miss, so watch till the end. But first, what is Perplexity Comet? Well, Perplexity AI's Comet is just a web browser that can not only think, but also act on and automate tasks for you end-to-end. And it's not just a browser with search, because it also combines the following five features, with the first being a full-featured browser based on Chromium, so you get all the tabs, extensions, and your usual workflow tools. Two, it's a sidebar that houses the Comet Assistant. So this is an AI agent that sees your screen and it answers questions, fills in forms, and runs routines. Feature number three is real-time web search, where it fetches up-to-the-minute answers and blends Perplexity's own AI models with external large language models. Feature four is its seamless in-browser automation, so it does tasks like scheduling, shopping, researching, and summarizing, and it happens all without needing to copy-paste anything between windows or apps. And feature number five is personalized memory, where Comet learns your habits, and it can suggest, organize, and execute tasks based on your browsing history or preferences. But here's where it gets super interesting, because Comet has both an AI assistant and an AI agent, and these are two distinct layers of AI capability within the Comet browser. They serve different purposes. So starting with Comet Assistant, this operates as a contextual AI helper, and it lives inside the browser's sidebar, and it does things including content analysis, like summarizing articles, emails, and web pages. It acts as a conversational interface to answer questions about current tabs using voice or text. It can carry out research, including explanations, translations, and fact-checking, and it features tab awareness, so it can reference and analyze content across multiple open tabs. So you can think of Assistant like a smart reading companion that helps you understand and process information more efficiently. Then there's Comet Agent, which goes beyond just processing information. It actually acts on your behalf, and some of its capabilities include web automation, like clicking on buttons, filling in forms, and navigating across, as well as web browsing autonomously. Plus, it executes tasks like booking flights, scheduling meetings, sending emails, and making purchases. It also integrates different services directly into the interaction, like connecting Gmail, Calendar, Google Drive, or your chat apps. And it can handle complex end-to-end workflows like unsubscribing from emails or managing shopping carts. And it basically acts as an assistant that can carry out tasks. So you can think of the key distinction between Comet Assistant and Comet Agent as being that Comet Assistant basically understands and explains, whereas Agent focuses on doing things and executing them. But here's how to get the most out of Comet Browser. First, you have to download and install Comet. Then you want to import your data. That's including your bookmarks, folders, maybe even passwords, autofill data, your Chrome extensions, browsing history, and preferences. Then the core features include the AI Assistant sidebar, which you can access with Alt-A, and this allows you to pull out this collapsible sidebar and start chatting. Next, you can also take advantage of one-click summarization, that's Alt-S, where every web page includes instant summaries of articles, videos, PDFs, and social media content. You can also use voice mode with Shift-Alt-V.
Open Perplexity Finance.
Got it. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
So this allows you to interact with the Comet browser entirely through speech without using your hands. You can do things like search or manage your tabs. So Comet's AI will actually organize your tabs automatically by grouping related tabs by topic, closing duplicate or unused tabs, creating color-coded collections, and maintaining context across tab switches. So let's see some of these features here with Perplexity. You can ask it and you can type in at mentions for shortcuts. For instance, I could use my SEO keyword trend radar tool and I could say, show me the latest 10 AI keywords that are trending over the last week. Here you can see these pro features. You can use Search with Pro, Research, or Labs to create projects from scratch. But here, I'm just gonna use what we have out of the box. here. It'll get all of my keywords, and then I can ask it to further organize my data in a table according to the highest keyword traffic that had the greatest change over the last 30 days. So here are some of the results. I can see that Reggie AI and Google AI Mode have had some of the most significant traffic changes over the last 30 days. It even shows me the sources for this data. First, I made an SEO keyword trend radar. Let's try to make something new here. Click on create a new space. And here I can actually just use the AI assistant and say, take over my browser to create a space for me that finds the latest trending keywords in my niche and organizes the data neatly. And here it's gonna start generating the space automatically for me. You can see it starts to take over this window here. First, it'll probably name the space here and put in the description. Next, it'll go in and choose the recency of the sources. And it says that it's going to find the latest with a step. And now it's checking out the different tabs, seeing how they can be used to improve the value of this space. Now it's finding more sources to find the latest information. Okay, now it looks like it's finished. It says that the browser has a dedicated space to automatically track and organize the latest trending keywords in the niche. I can scroll down here. Give me the latest keywords related to AI that are trending with the platform search data and difficulty. And it's going to grab all the different sources, and it's going to set up an example table showing me everything that I looked for. Here I can ask, show me the top 10 AI related keywords and all of the necessary metrics in a table for the last 30 days of data. I press enter. And it's going to go out, find all the sources for me, and print out this table showing me different keywords that are growing, their growth rate, and more. But make sure to make your own space and share it in the comments so I can check it out myself. Anyways, like and subscribe, share this video, and thanks for watching. Bye.